Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing well by God's grace. Today I'm back with your next chapter, which is Papaji's Moth. This is written by Arundhati Roy. Now this chapter of yours is a small part or an excerpt from the novel The God of Small Things. This is a very famous novel and this even won Arundhati Roy the Booker Prize back in 1997. So this is your novel. So your chapter or story is a small part taken from this thick book. And it's quite a good book for those who are interested in reading. They can read this. So the story which we are going to read is based in the small town of Imanem, which is a part of Kottayam and is in Kerala. So this is a South Indian story and that is why the title is Papaji's Moth. Papaji in Malayalam means grandfather and Mamachi in Malayalam means grandmother. We have different terminologies, like I call my grandmother Ammachi and my grandfather Appachan, but it varies from place to place. So this basically is a terminology we use for our grandparents. So Papaji's Moth basically means my grandfather's moth. So this story is about the childhood experiences of a set of fraternal twins. Papaji and Mamaji had two children. The boy was Chako, the daughter was Amu. Amu further had two kids who were fraternal twins, and they are the ones who are later on telling the story. This story begins when Papaji gets retired from his high ranking government job, which he was doing in Delhi. He was an entomologist, which means a scientist of insects. Now when he got retired, he came back to his hometown, which was Imanem in Kerala. When he got retired and he came home, his wife Mamachi, she started doing the job of pickle making commercially. Commercially means when we do something to earn money as a business. The Kottayam Bible Society, it once had a fair. Fair means your mela. And they requested Mamachi to set up a stall of her famous banana jam and mango pickles. She used to make very good jams and pickles. When she set up her stall, there were so many orders that she was not able to cope up with all the orders, and the orders kept on coming. She was so successful in that fair that she decided to start making pickles and jams and sell them. And she was so successful later on that she used to be busy the entire year. She used to get so many orders, but it also had a dark side to it. Why? Because her own husband, he was not happy with her success because he was having difficulty in coping up with the retirement. A person who has had a job for such a long time and all of a sudden he has nothing to do. So he was not able to accept the fact that he was without any work and his wife was becoming successful. And this made him realize that he was an old man. He was a retired old man while his wife was still in her prime age. Mamachi was 17 years younger than Papaji. And this made him jealous of his own wife. So this shows us that Papaji was not a good husband. He was not supportive of his wife. And there were many bad things he used to do to her, which we'll come to know further. Now Mamaji had conical corneas. Conical corneas means when your cornea, which should be round, takes a conical kind of a shape, which means you're not able to see clearly. So despite that, she was practically blind. She was almost blind. She had to use lens so that she could see something partially. And despite this health issue which she had, she was such a hardworking lady and she was working. But she did not get any support or any kind of help from her husband. He did not help his wife because of two reasons. One, because he was jealous. Second, because he thought that jam and pickle making was not suitable for a high-ranking official like him. He had retired, but he was still not able to come down from his high horse. He was still living a life as if he was a government official. He used to put on his court suit and he used to sit around in the house while Mamachi was making pickles. He would sit there, watch her doing everything, but all he would do was pass his time sitting in a court suit and feel more and more upset about being without a job. And then later on he would take out all this aggression on his wife, and every night he used to beat her with a brass flower vase. The beatings were not new, which means that he used to always beat her, but the frequency was new. Now he used to do it every day. And one day he got so jealous of her that he broke the bow of her violin. She used to play violin, and threw it in a river. Now one day what happened, their son who was studying in Oxford, he came back for vacation, and one evening he came across his father beating his mother. Being the son, he could not tolerate this. What he did, he went to the room, he held the arm of his father and he twisted it, and he warned him that this should not happen again. But this incident impacted Papachi in such a bad way. He took this negatively as well. Now after Chaco stopped him, Chaco was strong. He was practicing rowing boats. So he was quite strong. So obviously Papachi could not fight his strong son. So the rest of the day he sat stonily, very angrily, and he didn't know what to do. He was very angry. He could not hit his wife. So what he did, finally he went and he brought out his mahogany rocking chair, which is quite expensive. And he took out all his anger and frustration on the chair. He broke it to pieces. When he got finished with it, only the shreds of wood were left. He took out all his anger and frustration on the chair. After that, he stopped hitting Mamachi. He never touched Mamachi ever again, but he didn't talk to her as well his entire life. If he needed food or anything, he would convey the message. He would use intermediaries, or he would tell other people, the servant or his sister, but he never talked to her ever again till the day he died. He was so childish that he wanted to defame his wife, who was working while he was out of work. What he used to do in evenings, when he knew that visitors mostly come to your house in evenings, he would sit in the veranda of his house and pretend to sew buttons which were already intact. Matlab shirt pe button lagi hai aur acting kar raha hai usko silne ki. Why? To show to other people that my wife is a working lady and she does not take care of me. This is an old story. So at that point of time, working women were not supported much. So this even made the neighbors and other people feel more negative towards working women when they saw that the man of the house has to do a small thing such as stitching on his own because the wife is so busy working, which was entirely a lie. Later on, he bought a car, a second-hand car, from an Englishman in Munnar. It was a sky blue Plymouth. It was a very wide and long car, the one which you must have seen in your old movies. So then he became a very familiar sight. Familiar is something which you see every day. Aapke area mein bhi agar kisi ki special gaadi hai to aapke dhyan mein rehti hai, you know ki haan ye gaadi uski hai. So he also became a known sight in his town by, because every evening he would take out his car and like gedi marta tha, dheere dheere he would go around in his gaadi, and he would look so elegant outwardly. It was only to impress people and show off, while actually he used to wear that three-piece woolen suit which was not apt for the humid weather, and so he used to sweat so much inside, but outwardly he used to look so cool and show off in his new car. This car was his revenge. He never let anyone from his family as much as touch his car, forget about sitting in the car. Now why he was such a bitter man? He was working in Delhi as an imperial entomologist. Later on, when the British left India, he was promoted to the rank of a joint director in his workplace. And the year he retired, he was on the rank of a director, which is quite a very high rank. But despite his high rank, there was one major setback which he faced, which changed his life. The setback, जो धक्का लगता है, okay, that was not getting the moth which he had discovered on his name. How did he discover the moth? One evening he was sitting in the veranda and this moth fell in his drink. Now when he took it out, drink means his alcohol. Okay, so when he took out this moth, he realized that this was not a very usual moth. This was slightly different. How he could know this? Because he was the scientist of insects. So what he did, now it had fallen in his alcohol, so he kept it to dry. When the alcohol dried, he went and studied it in his microscope. And he was so excited when he realized that this moth was a new discovery. This was not something which was already known to us. So what he did, he caught the next train to Delhi, he went back and he applied for the moth to be named after him. He anxiously waited for 6 long months to get the due appreciation. But what happened? He was not accepted as the discoverer because he was told that this moth was a slightly different race of a well-known species. So this was no new discovery. That was still fine. The real hit to him came after 12 years. Why? Later on, when the reshuffling, taxonomical reshuffling was done, it was declared that the moth which he had discovered was actually a new species. But by that time, he had retired. Now, because he had retired, so the moth was finally named after the acting director of the Department of Entomology, who was Papaji's junior, whom he had always disliked. Now imagine you working for something and the credit instead of you is given to someone else. In fact, to someone else जो आपको पसंद भी नहीं है. So that is not easy to accept कि आप ये काम का क्रेडिट किसी ऐसे बंदे को दे दे यू डोंट इवन लाइक. So that was the real bro. इस इंसिडेंट से what happened after this incident, पापाजी became so bitter and so angry and he used to take all his frustration out on his family, especially मामाजी. This was the reason why he was so cruel towards everyone. All his family blamed the moth. The moth was something which had turned पापाजी into such a cruel person. He was always a very rude kind of a person, but after this moth incident, he was tormented himself. खुद भी परेशान रहता था and he used to torture everyone around him as well. Till the day he died, he used to wear a three-piece woolen suit every single day, even in the stifling heat of I'm just to look good. And to show off, Papaji used to wear that three-piece suit in such intense hot climate of Kerala. And he used to keep a photo from his young time on his dressing table. That photo was clicked in Vienna, where he had gone for some training, and that is where his wife had started taking violin lessons. It was all fine till the day his wife's teacher told Papaji that Mamachi played violin real well. She was concert class. She could play in a concert. She was so good. That was the day when Papaji stopped her classes. Why? Because he was a jealous kind of a person. He could not accept the appreciation of his own wife. This shows that he was not a good husband. He was all about himself. He also used to wear a gold pocket watch, which you must have seen in old movies, that it has a chain and round watch which you can open. Now we come to the end of the story where we come to know about Mamaji cutting a newspaper article, which is from the obituary, in which the death of Papaji has been mentioned. And it has been mentioned that he died from a massive heart attack. Although he was taken to the hospital, but he could not survive the heart attack and he died. It was also mentioned that he had not been keeping well since the last 6 months. obviously because he was so angry with everyone else, and he was torturing himself and he was torturing others as well. And in the end of the obituary, it was written that he survived by his two children and his wife Shoshama. Now the funeral scene. Mamachi was crying a lot when Papachi died. We can ask ourselves that why Mamachi is crying, because he used to always torture her and he didn't even like her and he didn't even talk to her. She was crying so much not because she loved him, but it was because she was used to him, means habitual. She was habitual of the beatings she used to get, and she was habitual of him being present around her when she used to work. So finally, Ammu, which is her daughter, she was telling this to her children, that human beings get addicted or habitual to very strange things. You just have to look around yourself and you will realize that people are habitual or addicted to such weird things. But that is how human beings are, because human beings are creatures of habit. She said, if you look around yourself, you will realize that beatings with brass was is not a very weird habit. There are more amazing or surprising habits people get addicted to. The important questions in this chapter are the character sketches, especially Papachi's character sketch. Then it is the questions based on Mamachi, that why she is a resilient woman. The questions of irony and humor, especially irony, is also important. Then comes your writing work, in which there is a question if this chapter is a reflection of male chauvinism, means male favoritism. This story is majorly based in the olden times, and that is when males were considered superior to women and women were not supposed to work or have a say in the family matters. So yes, this chapter is based on male favoritism. Why? Because this talks about a society which was dominated by males. In the chapter, we can clearly see that Mamachi is not treated as an equal partner, but she is treated very badly. So basically, Papachi is a two-faced person. He presents in front of the society that he's the perfect husband, the perfect father, but actually he does not treat his family well and he is not at all a good husband. He ill treats her like anything. Mamachi used to work hard in the factory, in her pickle factory. She used to be doing all the work, and all Papachi used to do was wear his three-piece suit and sit and watch Mamachi. And then he used to make sullen circles in the mounds of the chili or the turmeric which was kept. Achar mein we put spices. So jo dher laga hota tha mirchi and haldi ka, usme he used to make circles. Matlab time pass kuch bhi, instead of helping her out in any way. She's almost blind, but Papachi shows no sympathy towards his own wife. In fact, his habit of beating shows us the dominating nature of males over females. So the main idea of the story, before I wrap it up, I would like to tell you, is that how small things shape up the life of people. The moth not being named after him was a very small thing if we come to think about it. But this small thing not only affected Papachi's life, he to got very bitter, but it also affected the life of his family. Why? Because he started torturing them and taking out his frustration on them. So how this small thing kind of ruined or spoiled the life of so many people. He didn't treat them as his family. He took out all his frustration and anger on them, on his own family. And it did affect their life as well. Mamachi, she led a very kind of sad life because of Papachi. She used to be ill-treated, beaten mercilessly. He didn't talk to her, and even his children, he didn't let them sit in his car or touch his car. So how a small thing affected his behavior, changed his behavior, although he was a bad person in the beginning itself, but how this affected the lives of so many people, his children and his grandchildren as well. So that is what the main idea of this story is, that how small things can change so much. Take this story as an example and keep this in mind, that don't let small things affect you or your behavior, and don't take out your frustrations on the people around you, because it does affect lives in the long run. don't let bitterness or any bad thing which happens to you control your life or your behavior so much that you start wanting bad things for others. That was what Papaji did. He was so bitter that he used to take out his bitterness on other people. He used to make them suffer. That is not how it should be. So you have to come to terms, accept what you have come across in your life, and not treat people how you feel. You have to treat them the way you want to be treated. Don't let bad things which happen to you change you as a person. If you're a good person, stay a good person. Don't become a villain or a bad person like Papaji became. All because he was a very jealous person. Don't be jealous. What is meant for you is meant for you. What is not meant for you will not come to you, even if you feel bad for someone else's success. So jealousy does this to you. He died such a bad death, a massive heart attack, and people didn't even love him when he died. There was no one who was genuinely crying for him when he died. So that should not be the case. Learn a lesson. Don't be like Papaji. And yeah, take a lesson from Mamaji, be like her, because in spite of all the adverse conditions, she didn't stop working hard. She kept working for her family, and she didn't let the bad behavior of her husband affect her. She tolerated all that, and still she came out as a strong and a resilient woman, which is a good thing that we should learn from her. So I hope this story is clear to you. In case if you have any query or any doubt, do let me know. God bless you. Love your parents. Stay home and stay safe.